There you go, Donnie. That's it. That's it.
A little to the left.
My left or your left? Come on now, Donnie.
Do you think you could hurry up?
Hey, take it easy, all right? I'm trying my best.
Hey, who forgot to order anchovies?
Michelangelo.
Michelangelo, are you even going to help?
Yeah, come on,
Mikey. No way, bud. I can't even think till I've had my pizza.
5 degrees south should give us reception.
Nice work,
hey,
Big Mac.
Good work, Big Mac. Has a brain.
Pizza.
Michelangelo, I expect you're also indulging in your studies.
Mr. Splinter.
Whoa, totally wasn't expecting
Master
you,
Splinter.
Dude.
They're reviewing our accessory set on Fig Newton's figures.
Fig Newton's figure?
Yeah, come on, Master let's check Splinter. It out.
Watch it with us.
Let us see what all the hubbub is about.
I hope they get my good side. News.
Coming up next is Fig Newton's figure.
All right, it's starting.
I can't wait.
You want accessories? We got baby turtles? Got those too. It's the next Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles accessory set.
Hey, what's up, guys, and welcome back to Fig Newton's Figures. It's your guy, Fig Newton, and we're back today with another figure review. Today, it's the NECA Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles accessory set. This thing was really hard to come by. This was really a hot commodity, part of the whole Target Holothon thing that was going on about 2 months ago. Really excited to jump into this. Let's take a look at some of the artwork we get here on the front. These are the cartoon turtles. You can see they're kind of done in some different shades here. You know, you've seen this done over the years with the darker Donatello and the lighter kind of candy green Michelangelo. I think all these turtles here in the box are the same color, but we'll check that out and make sure. You get some more artwork here of the accessories that are included. You get that pizza monster with the VCR. You got the TV. You can see they got some video games going on. Looks like the Super NES, but with some Atari controllers. Let's take a look at the back of the box and see what we got going on back here. You can see there's some of the stuff that's included here in the box. You can see the TV there. You got the Rat King with the painting. Baxter Stockman holding that turtle tracker. And then you got the turtles down there on Big Mac. The accessories officially include Baby Leonardo, Baby Donatello, Baby Michelangelo, Baby Raphael, Big Mac, the video game console, TV with interchangeable screens, the cheese painting, pizza box, 2 VHS tapes, a backpack, ray gun, turtle tracker, Star of Hoboken, Baby Pizza Monster, Rocksteady helmet, which he's been missing now for a few years, the blowtorch, and multiple baby weapons. We're going to jump into all of that, guys. I can't wait. Quick look here at the side of the box. You get that NECA old FHE VHS font there on the side. It's more of the same. Here on the top, not much going on there. And then down at the bottom, if this barcode helps anybody track these guys down. And so with no further ado, guys, go slap a bandana on your face, grab me a slice of pizza, and let's take it back down to the sewers with the NECA TMNT accessory set. Okay, so I think it's pretty easy to see what we're working with here. There's a whole lot of snipping and stuff we gotta do to get these guys out. So what I'm gonna do is take every single piece out of this plastic package and we're gonna lay them out so we can see all of them at the same time. All right, guys, so now that we got all these accessories out of the box, let's just go ahead and take a look at all of them one by one, starting off here with the TV. You can see we get some brown paint with some gray paint here. This is a pretty cool looking old school TV. I would imagine the turtles are watching some cartoons or playing video games here on this thing. We also get the VCR here on top of the TV, and it's to my understanding that this would just unpeg. There's a few different pegs here on this TV. You would remove this here on top, and then you could slide some paper images in here to give you an image there on your TV screen, which is pretty cool, and I'll pull those out here in a second and we'll have a look at them. I don't know why I didn't pull those out already. This would go back into these four holes once you decide which frame you want in there. And then our VCR here on top of the TV can be removed as well. There's a hole there on the top and there's a peg on the bottom of the VCR. And I also believe that if you wanted to remove the VCR and just go with the full antennas, you know, no VCR, you could do that as well because the same peg there will actually fit on top. Get a couple different looks here with the TV. You get these books here holding it up where the other leg should be. Some paint there on the side, down to the very last detail, even on the back inside of that book. There on the binding. Very nicely done. Also going to get this VHS tape right here. And the VHS tape is pretty cool because it actually fits in the slot here of this VCR. I was actually kind of scared to pop it in there because I thought I might not ever see it again. Yeah, that happened to me a few times in the 90s. But it actually slides right back out just like that. You can even kind of have it maybe hanging halfway out the VCR. Moving on here, we get the backpack. I believe this fits on the regular size Ninja Turtles. As you see there on the back of the box, Michelangelo's wearing this. I checked to see if this maybe opened up, but it doesn't. It's actually molded closed. It would be pretty cool if this did open up. But I believe this would just go right over the arms of your Ninja Turtle, and that would hook on there. You know, I like this accessory. I know a lot of people said that with this accessory pack, maybe there's just a whole lot of extra stuff in here you don't need. But actually, I think I could find use for most of these accessories that come in here, including this one here. So this is definitely going to go on one of my Ninja Turtles. Moving on to the next accessory we get here in this accessory pack. We get this Mouser. I'm trying to see if his mouth will open up for me. And it does. I didn't want to damage the paint by forcing it. You can see some detailing there on the inside of the mouth. Some detailing there with the screws on the side of his head. If you missed out on the Mouser 5-pack that they released previously, and you need you a Mouser for your display, this will come in handy here. So I think this is a good accessory as well. I actually do have that 5-pack Mouser, so I guess I'm going to have 6 Mousers now. You can never have enough of these guys, though. There is some articulation here on the legs. They can go back and forth, just like this. Hinge there at the ankle. I believe the head. No, there's no articulation there on the head. But the mouth can hinge. Open and close. And then we get Big Mac here. I don't know if you guys remember this guy from the episode or not, but he was kind of a good bad guy robot. They did some good work here, it looks like, with all the details as far as the dark lines on this Big Mac. There's a whole lot of them. They're very dark and defined. It just looks awesome. He looks very 80s. And there is some good articulation on this robot. You can see here on the arms, they can kind of swivel up and down here. I believe we get some articulation here at the elbow. None there at the hand, but we do get it there at the elbow. Some swivel down here at the base. He's on some kind of a ball joint here under this part here, which gives him some more nice articulation. Moving back to this thing, I wasn't sure if this was bendy. It's just a hard plastic, so it's going to stay in this position here. And I believe that this might be, yes, it is removable. So you could take that off. I believe he can even come off of here. And then there's another accessory that's included here in the pack. I wasn't sure what this was at first, but it's actually going to pour on here to this gap on Big Mac's head. So we'll just go ahead and remove this little gun thing that he has, this like laser blaster. And then we'll insert this piece here and see how it looks. Okay, so here we go, and I got it in there. This is probably like the dormant, you know, good version here of Big Mac. And the other one with the guns, that's probably like the evil version of Big Mac, you know, ready to do some destructive type things. But yeah, he looks pretty good as far as the paint here on this guy. We even get some blue paint there for the lens. I like the articulation on him. He's definitely going to go on the display with the baby turtles. This pizza box here, pizza groove there on the top. It does have a hinge so it can open. Nothing much more there on the bottom. But it would open just like this. And inside, look at there, you get a pizza. Nice, hot, and fresh. The turtles are going to like this. You get some different paints there on the pepperoni, some little green, little peppers and stuff it looks like. It's just a whole pizza. We've seen, you know, them give you slices and stuff in the past, but this is just a whole pizza. So I think that's a good effect. Definitely going to use this all in the same, you know, baby turtle display when I put this all together. And then moving on to the Rat King painting here. It's just a piece of cheese. It's a triangular piece of what almost looks maybe like some Swiss cheese, but there's some really nice molding here on this frame. Looks like it's supposed to be like a gold paint here. On the back of the painting, there's actually like a little hole so you could actually hang this up somewhere in your display. This is going on the wall as well. So I'm going to find use for all of these accessories. I think it looks really cool. This looks like maybe it's some Leonardo da Vinci work here, just by the looks of it. And here we get the turtle tracker. This is a tool Baxter Stockman would use to track down the turtles. Get some really nice detail here on this turtle tracker. You can see everything down to the screen, to the little black paint around the buttons and stuff. These are all hand painted. So I mean, somebody's really getting down over there with the paintbrush. Looks really cool. There's no lacking on the paint here on this turtle tracker. As soon as I bust out my Baxter Stockman, this is going in his hands for sure. Here we got this like little blaster thing. What is this thing? Let me look at the back of the box. I can't even remember what this is. This is a ray gun. Duh, right? It's a ray gun. So yeah, this will probably go in one of my turtles' hands. But let's just look at the details. I mean, you get a little green button, a little red light button there. There's the trigger. You can see you get some red paint there. This thing looks really gnarly, really futuristic. So yeah, that's the ray gun. Okay, and then you're going to get these little pizza monsters. These guys look pretty cool. I got a couple other pizza monsters that are standing up. They give you two of these. It says on the back of the box you get one pizza monster and two VHS tapes, but they did it backwards. You get two pizza monsters and one VHS tape. I'm not complaining. I guess you can never have too many of these guys. Why not, right? They're on all fours. They're not articulated. So I'll find somewhere for these guys to crawl around. And then we get this diamond looking thing here. This is, I guess, the Star of Hoboken. I don't know why they call it the Star if it looks more like a diamond. It should be like the Diamond of Hoboken. Nice blue paint there. It's kind of translucent. There on the bottom, it's more of a flat matte blue. I actually got Shredder and the frogs in my display, so I might put this in Shredder's hands when it's all said and done. And then we get the weapons here. You can see I got the Michelangelo nunchucks there. Take a look there at the chains that come with this brown and gray paint that we get. I think this is some really good detailing as well, with the little tiny little chains in there. We're gonna see how these fit in the turtle's hands. We get two swords. We get two here for Leonardo. Pretty basic stuff here. You get the brown paint with the black paint around for the little details and stuff. I'm gonna see if these actually even fit in the turtle's hands. Of course, you get the size here for Raphael. Some black paint there around the handle in some gray and brown paint. All these weapons here have the same kind of paint scheme to them. Here's the bottom of the handle. Here's Donatello's bow staff. It's just the brown paint with that gray paint there. Pretty basic stuff. We got another accessory here. This is the helmet to Rocksteady. He didn't come with the helmet when he was first released. I have him, but he's still in the box, and I'm not gonna take him out just yet to throw this on. But here's what the paint looks like. You get some black lines. He's got the goggles there on the top. No paint inside the goggles, just a kind of a green finish. But this is a good accessory. He should have just came with this in the first place. No, don't know why he didn't, but glad to get that. And then we get this video game set. This definitely looks like an old school Super Nintendo set, but we get some like Atari looking controls there. Two buttons and a joystick. These definitely don't mash up, but I'm sure they did that to avoid the copyright stuff. Here on the back of it, there's a little hole where you might be able to squeeze like a little cable or something in there to give it a more realistic look, because I believe on the back of the TV, there's actually two holes there too. I don't know if there is a cord that's supposed to go in there or something, but maybe you could just make your own. Definitely gonna go in the display, probably set something up similar to what you see there on the box. Almost forgot, we get the blowtorch here, which you see Donatello holding on the front of the box. It's kind of bendy, has a yellow label here with some blue paint. I think this is pretty cool if we can get this into the turtle's hands. If not, this looks like, to be honest, I think this is going to fit in a regular scale Ninja Turtle hand. And then we get the Baxter Stockman head where he looks like Shredder. I don't think I'll be throwing this on my Shredder, maybe once or twice just to have a look-see. But you can see you get some nice detail. That's definitely Baxter Stockman. Here's a look at the back of the helmet. It's got the glasses on. They aren't removable. And so now that we've taken a look at all the accessories, let's go ahead and finally take a look at the turtles. And I think we're going to look at them two by two because I want to see if these are the same shade or if they are different shades. And to me, they definitely look like they're the exact same shade. They do have some different expressions on their face, though. Donatello's kind of looking down. Raphael's kind of looking straight at you. They got their letters there on their belt. Pretty similar look to what we get with the turtles, other than they're in a miniature type look. The back of the bandana is somewhat articulated, so you can actually spin that around. As far as articulation goes for these turtles, they can look up a little bit. They can look down just a little bit. The head doesn't really move too much. It's kind of tight, but that's about all it's going to allow you to do. A little bit of a tilt. You can do full 360 here at the head. The arms can go up about that high, but there's no articulation here at the elbow or on the hand, so that's pretty much all you're gonna get. You can imagine what kind of articulation you're gonna get there. Legs can go out about that much, can go, you know, back in about that much. As far as kicking back and forth, the shell is gonna kind of run into the leg here in the back, so if you wanted to move it forward, that's about all you're gonna get. And then down here at the feet, you get somewhat of a hinge, and you just really got to work with that hinge. These guys are kind of hard to stand up, but hey, with a little tack, anything is possible. Let's take a look at the other turtles. And we got Michelangelo and we got Leo here. Some different expressions again. I mean, Michelangelo, you could see the tongue here on his face. So that's pretty cool. That's kind of his personality. And then we got Leo here looking straight at you. I mean, these guys just look really cool. This is really why I bought this accessory set, was to get these baby turtles here. I mean, I paid about $59.99. I probably wouldn't buy this accessory set just for these accessories if it didn't have the turtles, but I will find some use for this other stuff. These NECA turtles, man, they're doing such a good job with it. I just can't resist. Let's move on to Fig's final thought. Okay, so for my final thoughts on the accessory set, there's something about Holothon that sends us turtle fans into another state of mind. Holothon to us collectors is somewhat what a full moon is to a werewolf. It creates this bloodthirsty frenzy for more TMNT stuff, and I'm definitely guilty of it as well. Look, this accessory set was definitely the crown jewel of it all, and considering how fast they sold out, I'm quite satisfied I snagged one. Now for the actual product itself, I think there's some good stuff in here, like the TV VCR antenna combo with the video game console and interchangeable screens, plus Big Mac with that excellent paint precision and articulation. Bravo. Some of the less exciting accessories being that ray gun and the Star of Aboken. And as far as the turtles, I think they look great. They add another dimension to my collection, and they're just a great alternate version. The articulation sucks, but I think I'll still have fun with them. Now for the price, I do think it's a little steep at $59.99 plus tax. I even think that maybe $50 is a little much for accessories, but to be honest, I think if this thing was even $80, people would still be running out to get it, and to be honest, I might be one of them. 7 out of 10 figs here for the accessory set. Look, sure hope you guys enjoyed this video, and if you did, make sure to hit that like button for me, and also, make sure to subscribe for even more TMNT reviews. That's gonna wrap it up for this one, but as always, thanks for watching, guys. We'll see you guys next time. It's your guy, Fig Newton. Fig Newton.
Bust the scientific approach to the course and the force is centrifugal. Can you find your way through the lyrics that be catching them? Throw another rhyme across the room, they be fetching them. And they take a loss to the master. And I throw his crazy blows and they knows I be plastering. All across the room, on the ceilings and the walls too. Punk little suckers didn't know I had the gall to come around, they block with my cock diesel system and turn it up to 10 and then start to diss them. And they didn't want to battle if they did when they saw me. They'd have opened up their trunk, but they tried to ignore me. Hey little suckers, I know you hear me calling you. Thought you wanted some, but I see that you're all into frontin'. Ain't no future in your frontin', so let's get it on like Marvin Gaye. Take the cash and sit it on the hood of your wick whack low ride.